Hello, hello, welcome to Quackalope, and today we're going to be taking a look at a Kickstarter preview copy of Chicken Heist. Now, Chicken Heist is a really interesting pressure luck, social deduction style party game. It's for 3 to 8 players, ages 13 and up, and plays in about 15 to 20 minutes. You and your friends are in a dangerous heist where trouble awaits every corner. You may work as a team or throw your friends under the bus to avoid getting caught. With the police hot on your tails, will you make another run to the vault? Or take off in the getaway truck. Now you may be looking at the table in front of me and thinking to yourself, there's a lot of cards going on this pile. But in all reality, this game is quick to learn, quick to play, quick to set up. All of these different cards are easy to sort. They have really clear, identifiable backs. And so let me go ahead and break down exactly how Chicken Heist plays and then talk to you about the things I really like about it and some of the concerns I might have with the game to determine if it's the right game for you and your gaming group to back. I do want to make sure I thank the guys over at Furtado Games for sending me this Kickstarter preview copy. Now, please remember, this is a prototype print of Chicken Heist. So the rules, the gameplay, some of the cards, even some of the artwork and elements like that will most certainly shift and adjust between now and when the Kickstarter actually launches. So if you're watching this, make sure you check out the Kickstarter page to see what elements have shifted and what has remained the same between this print copy and what will be arriving to backers. I know they're gonna have a Kickstarter exclusive copy that includes a whole wide kind of crazy range of different types of chickens, because you have a whole mix of chicken characters. On the table in front of me, there's a few things going on. First of all, there's this set of 10 timer cards. Those are gonna be the rounds or the course of the game. Underneath each one of these is going to be a different event, like a shootout where all the blue chickens would be caught, a negotiation where all the yellow chickens would be caught, a driver signal letting you know that the driver is about ready to take off. There's only one more signal in this round before the driver leaves and everyone that's left behind is caught. Now to play the game, you're going to be taking one of four different actions. Now first of all, you're going to have a specific chicken character, like I just pulled the pirate chicken. And each of those characters will have a special ability. On your turn, you could play any number of supply cards, which are quick one-time actions. You could play your chicken's special ability once, and you can take one of four different actions. Now the four different actions you take are either going to increase your wealth, your victory points at the end of the game, or manipulate the game state in an interesting way. So you could peek, so you could gain some information, and check what the card underneath the next time signal is. That's the next card that'll be pulled so that you're ready to respond accordingly. You could take some wealth for yourself if you feel pretty confident that you know what's going on the board. Look at that and just slide that underneath your chicken. You could tinker, which means you could manipulate the board, just in case maybe that's not the card that you wanted to pull and you already knew what it was. Or you could resupply, which is to take two more of these action cards that allow you to manipulate things or basically take an extra turn later on in the game. Like I just got influence, which lets me pick who the leader is going to be, and teamwork, which allows me and another teammate to swap two of these cards on our turn. So it's basically like an additional tinker action. Once you and everyone around the table have taken one of those four actions, you'll come to the preparation phase. That's where you and anyone else could play any of these action cards that they have remaining in their hand. If they wanted to change the board state, manipulate cards, stop someone from doing something, or even assign someone a different chicken card or pass the leader card on to someone that wasn't in the turn order. Then you're going to decide what action you're going to take this round. You could stay, which means you stand your ground, you commit to whatever this event is. You could hide, that means you're going to avoid the next event, but if the next event doesn't affect you, your hide card is going to be discarded, so you could only use that potentially once, or you could run. That's where you take all the loot that you've collected and you get out of town, hoping that everyone else that's playing the game will leave with less loot than you or get caught. I mean, that's also another good way for you to end up winning the game. Let's say this time we chose to stay. Everyone will put their card in the center and then everyone will reveal at the same time, letting the group know exactly what action they're going to take, and then the next round gets revealed. Here we have the vault failsafe. The vault crew is caught, which means the red chicken crew, the pirate chicken, I would be caught, my pirate card would be flipped over, and my money would no longer count. I'm out of the game until the next game starts. But for instance, if I had had some preemptive information letting me know that this was going to be the red card, and I had played hide this round, I would be okay. I'd be able to continue in the game and continue cycling down looking for the next driver's signal. That's the key. Every single round, you're going to be adding another piece of loot to the getaway truck. And the getaway truck is going to leave the moment the second driver's signal comes out. So let's see here. So here it is right here. So if that driver's signal had just been pulled, I would have needed to know that and needed to play the run card in order to get out of the city and to collect and share this treasure with whoever else was able to escape. And the way you'll do that is you'll pass it around and you'll each take one, starting with the leader player for whatever that turn was. And the winner of the game is going to be the person that has the most treasure, gets out of the city with the most loot. If you get caught or you don't leave before the final driver signal has happened, you lose the game. So that's Chicken Heist in essence. It's this weird dynamic of taking a piece of loot for yourself and trusting your neighbor to tell you what that card is so that you can do the same thing for them next turn. You have to negotiate this deck and try to preemptively understand what's coming up without letting everyone else take a lot of loot ahead of you. I mean, if you're checking these cards every single turn, you're not gonna have any victory points. And someone could scramble the cards and mix up this pile anyway. So there's this really nice pressure luck element to the game. It's a party game with what I think is a fair amount of depth, complexity, and choices. And I really like it. I think it's a really interesting game. One of the things I like the most about Chicken Heist is the fact that the theme and the gameplay mechanics work so well together. If you have a group of five or six people, you end up dividing into little tribes. You'll have two or three people that are working really closely for the first few rounds of the game. Hey, I'll check this card if you check the next one so that we can talk with each other and let each other know what's going on. Or I'll take loot this time if you check the card, and then I'll do the same thing for you next turn. Or if you have one of these teamwork cards, hey, I know this is bad, so I need you to help me. I need you to select this one down here so that we can swap these and just get it out of the way. Make it so that it's not a problem for us anymore. This game really leans into the theme, and because of the limited information, the limited knowledge that you have, you have to work with the people that are at the gaming table around you to collect loot and get out of the city. If you don't, you're going to be caught. But the problem is, if you do, they might get out of the city with more loot than you. So when you get down to these final rounds, it kind of becomes a shove your friend under the bus sort of dynamic. I want to leave with the van full of loot, but I don't want you to. I don't want you to come along with me, because then I have to share it all with you and I don't get to win the game. This is one of the things that I think makes Chicken Heist such a interesting and unique little party game. It only takes about 15 to 20 minutes to play, and the first time we learned how to play it, it probably took 3 to 5 minutes to work our way through the rulebook, understand the cards, and be ready to start cycling into it. It's something that I wouldn't be intimidated to get out and bring to the table with a party of new gamers or people who don't game much at all. So I enjoy the gameplay. I enjoy that the mechanic and the theme of the game seem to go hand in hand. They encourage you to act or work in what feels like a heist situation. Along with that, I really appreciate that the game is quick to play, quick to learn, and easy enough that I could introduce it to a lot of new gamers while still having a reasonable amount of depth and complexity when it comes to the choices you're making. How far do you press your luck? I really like that it's a game that leaves you with a little bit of a blind. How far can you push this game system to reward you? How much loot can you leave the city with? I also, and this is what drew me to the game in the first place from their social media posts, and why I reached out to be a Kickstarter previewer for this game, I really like the artwork. There's so much life and character with all of these chickens, and yeah, I know, my name is Quackalope, I may be a little biased towards birds, but you can't look at these chickens and not think to yourself that they're adorable. It's a fun yet serious little theme, and for a pressure luck game or a kind of play chicken style game, if you're familiar with what that game is, I think it works perfectly. I think the theme, the gameplay, the mechanics, the art style, really make this game fun and inviting to pull out to the table. And you can tell they've paid a lot of attention to detail here. We have the vibrant colors that clearly indicate what each type of card is going to be. Very simple and clean graphics. The texts on the card are easy to understand. And even the terminology, I never had a problem understanding what it meant, what I should do. I mean, collecting loot, I'm tinkering to manipulate cards, I'm revealing information. Everything is clean and designed in a way that makes it as accessible as possible. Now that being said, I do have a few comments about the game that may help you determine if it's the right game for you to back. First off, it is a party game. And that being said, it's probably played best with about 5 to 6 people. On the box here, it says that it can be played from 3 to 8, but in my playtests, I found that the 5 to 6 player zone is almost perfect for this style of game. It's just enough that your turns go quick, and you're able to cycle through actions fast without people kind of being stagnated on deciding which cards they want to play. And it's also large enough that you're able to make coalitions or get enough information moving around the table so that you can start manipulating or at least pressing your luck in certain elements. I found that with 3 and 4 player groups, at times, especially early on in the game, we just didn't know what was happening. There wasn't enough information disseminated across the game state, not until we were around the 5th or the 6th round, and we'd all been able to take an action to kind of check some cards, manipulate the board a little bit. That being said, I've been in communication with the team over at Furtado Games, and they're looking at all the ideas that the community's been sending them about how to make certain elements or certain player counts of this game as strong as possible. And so there's a good chance that by the time this comes to Kickstarter, officially, some of those elements will be adjusted or manipulated in a way that make lower player counts a little bit more rewarding. But if you have a group of 5 or 6 people, or let's say you're going to play this at home with your family, I think this is a fantastic little game to pull out and get to the table. The two other notes that I want to point out about this game is that there is player elimination, so if you run early on, or let's say your chicken's caught, you flip over your card and you have to wait until the game cycles. And then at some stages of the game, specifically when it comes to playing some of your action cards, there can be a little bit of player stagnation when you're determining which card you want to play, how you want to manipulate the board, whether or not you want to introduce an entirely new random element to the game state. Because it's a pressure luck game, those elements tended to slow down the game in certain areas. So if you have a gaming group or a member of your gaming group that likes to sit and ponder for a little bit too long, this is a game that kind of rewards itself for being fun and silly and just seeing how far and how quick you can go. It's not one that you're supposed to sit down and painstakingly think about or map out or try to do the math of what cards have been played, what's been revealed, where's my memory patterns going. So that's a very quick overview of Chicken Heist, and I'll have an official set up and play video coming out as well. So if you think this game looks right for you or you've been lucky enough to get your hands on it, go check out that video, see exactly how the game plays, and get prepared to bring it to your table. I really enjoy this lightweight, pressure luck party game, and if it seems like the right game for you, I'd be willing to bet that it is. Whatever the case, thank you for watching this video. I hope it's been informative. I hope it's given you a better understanding of Chicken Heist and whether or not it fits your gaming group. If you have watched to this point in the video, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. I put out new videos every single week, and I'd love to have you be a part of the community here. But whatever you do, remember to do the important thing. Get out and play some games. We'll see you next time. Thank you.